All right, we are back for round two of the first Eternal Weekend event. I suppose this one actually is named Eternal Weekend Caracas, technically. Playing against a local friend of mine, Kenzie Endress. Presumably playing Rug. If I had to put him on any day. I think I'm gonna actually. I'm gonna keep this on the draw versus Rug. It is a little susceptible to Wasteland and then missing my third land, messing a land drop, but I think the spells in the hand are good enough itself that I am willing to. Game one is such a good matchup. I am willing. Keep a little bit riskier of a hand. Again, like, we have 18 mana sources left in our deck still, plus then, like, the draw two, so we're gonna cantrip here. So, yeah, this looks like Rug. Actually, it is Rug, not... make a decision. Cards. Awkward. Follow up with it. Because I can't fetch Trop with this, or like, I'm going to just play the Trop. Hopefully trade with the Delver. Trade Icefang with the Delver. Unflipped, hopefully. And be able to Abrupt Decay next turn. This does go very bad, assuming, again, they flip the Delver. They're going to preordain now, and then if they have a Wasteland, that's very bad for me. Like, that's horrifically priced into casting this in a less enticing spot than I would otherwise. Yeah, here's a way. We're going to start falling behind pretty badly right now. But this Astrolabe is a very good pickup because we can turn that on next turn. To give Icefang Death Touch hope. And again, Fate a Bolt, and then turn on our mana a little bit better to towards the Red Horde Arcanist. That's not blocking here. Not second Delver. Top bottomed with the second. Top topped with the first. Fetch just to play around Stifle. I'd rather, again, not have. Have to, like, we have the Sword Splashers and Abrupt Decays to answer what's going on. I'm gonna let them reveal before they draw that. I think I'm gonna unfortunately have to pitch the. Those means that they have a lightning try to cast. Can't have forced blue card. So now we're actually in a very good spot drawing specifically Misty Rainforest or Forest. Because we can Abrupt Decay and Swords to Plowshares. Two Delvers. Having to pitch Uro kind of sucked, because that is how we will inevitably win this game. Another two Swords Plowshare is now very good for us, which means we can hold this for an Oko. I'm going to Swords these both on upkeep. Know that one card in his hand is a Brainstorm. Give us the best chance to kind of play around a Forced Negation and potentially a Daze with at least one of them. I think I still do it, just my life total high. Alright, that one getting dazed kind of sucks. But it is what it is. I think it may have been aggressive. It only really punishes us if there's a follow-up threat. Like there is in another Delver. Just gonna need to hope that they don't flip a lightning bolt. Force negation. Trying to play around that. Okay, that's to break the force negation. May have stabilized. Well, I lost that game because I did not put a stop on. So, post board gets very good for us.
Not correct.
But I polluted Delta. At Sylvan's. At negations. Got two Force of Wills.
Can be very awkward versus multiple
versus Clothis. Try to fade around Surgical if we don't have draw ground seal. Give him the most auspicious start of Carpet Go, or Planes Go, not, or Planes Astral Go. God, it's really late for me already. I'm not gonna lie, I'm tired. I'm not gonna run out the ground seal yet, just because I know how important it is. I'm gonna wait till next turn. Assuming they play a second land, I can also like Burrow plus Ground Seal. And then this way, like, they commit a drift. Them that I shouldn't you actually shouldn't do. Have the available if I want. Also, mad punished by surgical by doing this. He has exactly surgical in his hand, but I don't think he does. Okay, we've drawn three lands. And then Oko is our draws for the entirety of the game so far, so that's not looking too great. But hopefully the three drop they had was Klothys, so we can nuke that threat of Oko. And okay, they have their they have an Uro of themselves, so they're playing like the bigger. I want to do this. I want to get one more card in the. I'm going to Swords the Delver. Escape the Uro. And then I have the option to play Oak if I would like. But I don't want to pass here. I don't. With carpet in play, I never need to play into Daze, so it's just not worth playing into it. I realize I played. I could have gotten my Uro Daze last turn. Because I just didn't play a land first, but I wanted to give myself the most information to figure out what lands I did want to be playing. I'm gonna brainstorm here. My Uro gets elked. Fine. Don't want to use Astrolabe. Not elk the Astrolabe. Attack the Oko. They trade with the, or block the Uro with the Dreadhorde, not trade, it's more a chump. Alright, been a long day, so I'm kind of already, like, tired. This event is also going to be 10 rounds, so expect me to say the wrong thing quite a bit. Does it say row of their own? Okay. I'm gonna swords their row. I'm gonna get their there. This tells me that they left some number of forces in, which I would expect them to. Maybe Nile Spellbomb becomes a little bit more appealing. I probably should have waited, but it's fine. I'm just gonna swords the Delver now, so I can get the Oko dead. I'm gonna wait for him to play Tarmogoy for a Hooting Mandrills or some another threat, because then I can then I'm gonna be able to Dead of Winter. And then escape Uro. So this is not effective at protecting their Uro unless they have a Lightning Bolt or Brazen Bow or something, Snapcaster Mage. More than likely not Snapcaster Mage, but just unless rattling off the things that they could possibly have. And, okay, so they're trading the food. Down goes Oko. I'm just gonna pass now. Okay. Elk my Delver. Suppose that's a thing you can do. Here, Mac, have an Astrolabe. So I'm gonna do this to get both arrows in the yard. Drop into play. That, I didn't mean to delve the extra Uro, but it's fine. Doesn't matter. I mean, it kind of does, but not. It's not going to have a huge impact on the rest of the. But yeah, let's just get another, play another Oko out. So we have another food ready to attack. And also threaten to steal something next, steal a threat with the next turn. He slammed me like it mattered. All right, now comes the part of the game that takes a while. I missed. I'm gonna pretend like it doesn't matter. That actually kind of does matter. 9, 14, 9, 15. So they would be at 16 in a fetch land. So that one turn did matter a little bit. So again, we're just like been pretty like this is just formality gameplay. Eating up some clock. My cards involve lots of triggers that take up a lot of time. But 14 minutes is enough to win a game by a lot. I don't want a spell bomb. I don't want these spell bombs. And I want Carpet to be able to brick Daze and Spell Pierces from the Ashes. Again, just because, like, kind of competes with Carpet in a way where I could just be like getting doubling my mana based on what they have, or at least pseudo doubling my mana. From the Ashes just does straight Stone Rain them. Or Armageddon, not Stone Rain. Yeah. Semantics, but it is what it is. This hand is very bad. I'm going to be shipping it. This hand is better. I'm not in love. I'm going to bottom a draw. Like, I don't want to spend so much time spinning my tires trying to brainstorm, but. And I think, like, Oko is definitely, like, I do need to prioritize the fact that I do need to actually win the match. So keeping the Oko in my hand is worth a lot. There's all the fetching that made it. Planes. And it kind of signifies that we have bad mana, so it kind of entices them to spend a 2-for-1 on that. Don't need. I guess we kind of do need this in a capacity, but it makes this more likely. or this more likely to resolve, and these are the two of the more important cards in the matchup. Being Oko and Ground Seal. Ground Seal turns off Dreadhorde Arcanist, Clothis, all those. Play around Daze and or Daze plus Pyroblast potentially. And I can decay a Oko if that comes down. Clothis, I can just climb Ground Seal. Uro is a little okay, that's Clothis. Rainstorm make him think I care about this. I'm drawing at least one. So now this Clothis is a blank cardboard. Diminish all